Hello everyone, I am Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called Finance Current Affairs. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try and discuss them with the help of different questions. So before moving on to question number one, if you are there for the very first time, please do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon so that you can be notified about all our upcoming videos. You can also join our Telegram group. The free PDFs of these sessions will be available on this group. So if you want the access to those PDFs, you can join this group. The link is in the description below. Moving on to first question then. The government has now launched the much awaited National Single Window System for investors and businesses. The launch was planned by DPIIT much earlier, but it got delayed due to the second wave. Identify the correct statements in this regard. So recently, a national single window system has been launched by the government. It was planned to be launched earlier only, but it got delayed due to COVID. So why this platform has been launched? What is the basic purpose it's going to serve? Let's discuss that first and then we'll come back to the question. So recently, the government has launched this platform, which is going to be helpful for investors, the businessmen who want to do business in India. अब आपको कोई भी बिजनेस करना है उसके लिए आपको अलग अलग क्लियरेंसेस चाहिए होते हैं, अप्रूवल्स चाहिए होते हैं, सेंट्रल डिपार्टमेंट से कोई अप्रूवल्स चाहिए होते हैं, स्टेट डिपार्टमेंट से कुछ अप्रूवल्स चाहिए होते हैं. सो उसके लिए आपको मल्टीपल पोर्टल्स पे अप्लाई करना पड़ता है, फाइनली आपको अप्रूवल मिलता है एंड देन आप बिजनेस स्टार्ट कर सकते हो. सो इट्स अ रियली वेरी टीडियस प्रोसीजर टू गेट द अप्रूवल्स फॉर स्टार्टिंग अप योर बिजनेसेस इन इंडिया. यू नीड टू अप्लाई फॉर डिफरेंट अप्रूवल्स ऑन डिफरेंट पोर्टल्स वेयर सम अप्रूवल्स माइट बी नीडेड फ्रॉम द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट्स एंड फ्रॉम द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट्स एंड. सो अ लॉट ऑफ टाइम एफर्ट गेट्स वेस्टेड इन दैट वेरी थिंग. In order to save that time, in order to make sure that you easily get the approvals and you can easily start up the business, this portal has been launched by the government. So which ministry has launched it? The Ministry of Commerce and Industry has launched this very system, which is going to be helpful for investors, for the businesses, and it will improve the ease of doing business. सो आपको जब इजीली अप्रूवल मिल जाएगा किसी भी बिजनेस को स्टार्ट करने के लिए, इतना इजी प्रोसीजर होगा तो ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा इन्वेस्टर्स आपके यहाँ इन्वेस्ट करना प्रेफर करेंगे, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा बिजनेसमैन आपकी कंट्री में बिजनेस करना प्रेफर करेंगे, विद इन इंडिया भी ज़्यादा लोग बिजनेस प्रेफर करेंगे क्योंकि वो स्टार्ट करना काफ़ी ईजी हो जाएगा. सो इससे हमारी जो रैंकिंग है ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस में वो भी इम्प्रूव होगी. इफ़ यू रिमेंबर इन द लास्ट वीक्स सेशन वी डिस्कस्ड that the World Bank used to provide a report on the ease of doing business, but the World Bank has now finally decided to discontinue it because of the various irregularities which were going on with respect to the data which was coming in this very report. So that's another thing of which I wanted to remind you, that that very report has now been discontinued. But still, if such steps are being taken to improve the way you get the approval for starting any business, it will obviously improve the way the business is done in India, improve the ease of doing business, and more businesses will be encouraged to start up their units in our nation. Okay. So the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade, it's basically the department under the ministry, planned about starting up this portal earlier, but because of COVID, it got delayed. So we have already discussed why this portal is being launched. Let's discuss briefly the points once again. One is that it's going to be a one-stop shop for all approvals and clearances. अभी भी आपको approval और clearances तो चाहिए business के लिए, लेकिन अलग-अलग जगह पे apply करने के बजाय एक ही जगह पे आपको सारे clearances मिल जाएंगे. It will enable obtaining approvals as well as clearances needed by investors, entrepreneurs, businesses in India. The platform will do away with the need for multiple applications across different portals. आपको अलग-अलग जगह, अलग-अलग portals पे apply करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है. एक ही portal पे आपको सारे approvals मिल जाएंगे. All approvals will be available on this single portal, and it will be available at a click of mouse without the need to go through different websites, different portals, and apply for different clearances. इन सब से फायदा क्या होगा? एक ही जगह पे सब कुछ होगा, उससे क्या बेनिफिट होंगे? उससे ट्रांसपेरेंसी आएगी और अकाउंटेबिलिटी इंश्योर होगी. ओके, सो ऑल दिस थिंग इज गोइंग टू ब्रिंग अबाउट मोर ट्रांसपेरेंसी, अकाउंटेबिलिटी एंड रिस्पॉन्सिवनेस इन दिस इकोसिस्टम ऑफ गेटिंग द क्लियरेंसेस, बिकॉज एवरीथिंग इज बीइंग हैंडल्ड थ्रू अ सिंगल प्लेटफॉर्म. यू कैन अप्लाई देयर, यू कैन कीप अ ट्रैक ऑफ व्हाट क्लियरेंसेस यू हैव ऑलरेडी गॉट, व्हाट आर पेंडिंग, इफ देयर आर एनी क्वेरीज दैट विल ऑल्सो गेट रीड्रेस्ड. So an applicant dashboard would be up there to apply for any approval which you need, to keep a track, to respond to the queries. Services include Know Your Approval, Common Registration Form, State Registration Form, Document Repository, E-Communication. So सारे services आपको एक ही portal पे मिल जाएंगी. इससे एक और benefit होने वाला है. वो benefit क्या है? जो बाकी schemes हम run करते हैं, जो इंडिया में business करना encourage करती है, जैसे कि PLI scheme आजकल बहुत चल रही है कि ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा लोग इंडिया में manufacture करें, इसके लिए कुछ incentive दिए जा रहे हैं. So if it is easy to get an approval, to get a clearance, then obviously more people will come and start business in India. They will try and utilize these schemes to benefit from doing business in India. So different schemes hai, inko bhi strength milegi is very step se, kyunki business karna easy ho jayega, approval lena easy ho jayega. So jo bhi government apni schemes run kar rahi hai business encourage karne ke liye, wo aur zyada encouraged honge India mein aake business karne ke liye. So it will provide the strength to other schemes which focus on more companies setting up their units in India or more Indian companies doing business in India in order to give a boost to different schemes. This step is going to be really very helpful. So this was all about this piece of information. Coming back to our question, first statement is incorrect because it's the Ministry of Commerce and Industry which has come up with this scheme. Second is correct that it's a portal which is going to be a one-stop shop for approvals. And third is also correct that you need not apply for approvals, different approvals on multiple sites. So second and third are correct. That's why answer is option D. Moving on to next question now, which says the DICGC Amendment Act 2021 came into force with effect from September 1st for banks insured under DICGC Act. DICGC stands for the Deposit Insurance and the Credit Guarantee Corporation. So this very corporation is going to pay the depositors of around 21 stressed cooperative banks, including PMC, up to 5 lakh within what stipulated time period? अगर आपको याद होगा तो जब ये अमेंडमेंट एक्ट आया था, हम लोगों ने एक सेशन में इसके बारे में डिस्कस भी किया था कि कैसे ये टाइम बाउंड मैनर में डिपॉजिट इंश्योरेंस के क्लेम्स सेटल करने में हेल्प करेगा. व्हेन दिस अमेंडमेंट केम अप, वी डिस्कस्ड दैट विद इन सर्टेन स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम पीरियड इट विल मेक श्योर दैट वट एवर अमाउंट इज बी इज इंश्योर्ड, द पीपल आर द डिपॉजिटर्स आर एबल टू गेट द क्लेम ऑफ दैट वेरी अमाउंट इफ देयर रिस्पेक्टिव बैंक इज in any kind of a stressful situation. Suppose the banks are not doing well, they are into some stressed situation and they are not able to pay the money. So if those banks are insured with DICGC, then up to 5 lakh is the amount which the depositors can claim from this DICGC. So 5 lakh tak का जो पैसा है डिपॉजिटर्स का वो सेफ होता है. अगर बैंक की कोई भी स्ट्रेसफुल सिचुएशन आती है जब आपको बैंक नहीं पे कर पा रहा, तो DICGC 5 लाख तक का अमाउंट आपका जो इंश्योर्ड है वो आपको पे करेंगे. सो अब जब अमेंडमेंट एक्ट आई थी तो उस पर बोला गया था कि कितने टाइम पीरियड में ये सेटलमेंट हो जाना चाहिए. दैट एक्ट प्रोवाइडेड द स्टिपुलेटेड टाइम पीरियड विद इन विच दिस अमाउंट शुड बी सेटल्ड एंड दैट पीरियड वॉज 90 डेज. द आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी, 90 डेज. सो रिसेंटली this very amendment act came into force from 1st September onwards. So within first 45 days, whoever wants the claim, they need to apply with the bank, and the bank needs to tell the DICGC that this is the list of those depositors whose claim you have to make, and then within next 45 days the DICGC will basically process the claim. So let's see this piece of information. The DICGC will pay the depositors of around 21 stressed cooperative banks. So PMC है जैसे, ऐसे कई और cooperative banks हैं जो stressful situation में हैं, जो अपने depositors को पैसा repay नहीं कर पा रहे हैं. Because of the stressful situation, they are not able to repay their depositors. Because those banks are having the deposit insurance, thus the depositors are safe. Up to 5 lakh amount they can claim. So whosoever wants to make a claim as per the latest amendment act, their claim will be settled within 90 days. All right. So necessary instructions have been issued to the banks to submit the claims within 45 days after obtaining the willingness of depositors to claim insurance. So jo bhi depositor hai jo apna paisa क्लेम करना चाहता है, उन्हें अपने रिस्पेक्टिव बैंक को अपनी विलिंगनेस बतानी होगी कि 5 लाख तक का अमाउंट हमारा इंश्योर्ड है, हमें अभी तक पैसे नहीं मिले हैं, प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट वी आर एबल टू क्लेम दिस वेरी अमाउंट. सो विद इन 45 डेज आपको बैंक्स को इसके बारे में अपनी विलिंगनेस बतानी है, एंड द बैंक्स नीड टू टेल DICGC दैट दिस इज द लिस्ट ऑफ दोज पीपल whose claims are pending. So within 45 days the banks need to do this very thing. and then the verification and the settlement of claims on submission by the banks will be done by DICGC within next 45 days. So, 1st September से पहले 45 days till 15th October आपको banks को अपनी willingness बतानी है that please provide us this much amount. We had the deposit insurance and then banks need to notify about the same to the DICGC. Within next 45 days till 30th of November, DICGC will finally prepare the list that okay will approve the list that okay these are the claims and it will provide that very amount within next 45 days. Only those depositors who have submitted their willingness to the insured banks will get money. अब आपको नेसेसरी डॉक्यूमेंटेशन करना है, इंफॉर्मेशन है जो बैंक्स को प्रोवाइड करनी है, तो आपको आपको अपनी विलिंगनेस का डिक्लेरेशन देना पड़ेगा दैट वी वांट दिस मच क्लेम, दिस इज आर नेसेसरी डिटेल्स, प्लीज मेक श्योर दैट आर नेम इज देयर इन द क्लेमर्स लिस्ट. सो द लास्ट डेट टू सबमिट द डिक्लेरेशन ऑफ विलिंगनेस एंड अपडेट एनी अदर डॉक्यूमेंट और इन्फॉर्मेशन टू हेल्प बैंक्स टू इंक्लूड देयर क्लेम्स इन द लिस्ट इज October 15th. तो 15 अक्टूबर से पहले पहले आपको अपनी विलिंगनेस बैंक को देनी है, बैंक को लिस्ट प्रिपेयर करके DICGC तक पहुंचानी है. द बैंक्स आर रिक्वायर्ड टू सबमिट अ क्लेम लिस्ट बाय 15th अक्टूबर एंड अपडेट द पोजीशन एज ऑन 29th नवंबर. दिस विल इनेबल द DICGC टू फाइनली सेटल द क्लेम्स एंड डिस्चार्ज द इंश्योरेंस लायबिलिटी इन फुल. DICGC will do the verification and settle the claims within 45 days. So, आपने within 45 days till October 15 as a bank सारी list provide कर दी DICGC को, अब वो final उसको approve करके November 30 से पहले पहले सब claims settle कर देंगे. So, within 90 days ये सारा settlement हो जाएगा. इसके under around 21 cooperative banks को instructions दिए गए हैं कि जो भी amount उन्होंने claim करना है वो कर सकते हैं. So this was the important piece of information which I wanted to share. Now moving ahead to the last question. Identify the China's top selling property developer that recently came into limelight due to the ongoing crisis where it owes more than $300 billion and has run short of cash and investors are worried that a collapse could pose systemic risk to China's financial system and can spread around the world. So recently a major crisis is going on with China's property developer and you have to identify the name of that very company which is into the crisis. So the answer to this question is option B, Evergrande. So Evergrande is the property developer which is going through a crisis situation. So let us discuss about this very crisis. First of all, talking about Evergrande, it's China's second largest property developer. So it is into real estate business. It makes the properties, sells them. It's not just a property developer because it has grown as a property developer. It has diversified its business in other areas as well. It has expanded to 280 cities and has around 1300 real estate projects. So ye ek property developer hai, real estate business. जो है चाइना का बहुत मेजर बिजनेस है जो काफ़ी ग्रोथ में कंट्रीब्यूट करता है. एंड दिस एवरग्रैंड इज द सेकंड लार्जेस्ट प्रॉपर्टी डेवलपर ओवर देयर. इट हैज प्रेजेंस इन 280 सिटीज. इट्स द ओनर ऑफ अराउंड 1300 रियल एस्टेट प्रोजेक्ट. सो इससे आपको पता लग रहा होगा कि ये कितनी बड़ी कंपनी है. Lakhs and lakhs of people have been employed over there and it has presence in major cities. It is having various real estate projects. So from here we can get an idea about the extent of business which this company has. Then what happened that it went into a crisis situation and what is the crisis situation which it is facing? So Evergrande, once China's top selling property developer, owes more than $300 billion, has run short of cash and investors are worried that a collapse can pose systemic risk to the China's financial system and spread around the world. So around 300 billion तक का amount है जो इन्होंने repay करना है और ये repay नहीं कर पा रहे. They are having debt of around 300 billion which they are not able to pay. They are not able to pay the interest amount, the principal amount. Moreover, they are not able to generate the cash also which can be helpful for them to pay this amount. Despite of having such a large amount of property, they are not having cash flows with which they can repay their debts. And the investors are worried that the situation can become more worse. The China's financial system can be hampered due to this and its effects might be seen in other parts of the world as well. Evergrande accumulated $300 billion worth of debt as it acquired assets and expanded over the years. However, property sales have been declining and the company will possibly continue to fall, constraining its cash flow further. So initially, real estate business was doing really, very well. If we go back to the time period of 2000s, this was an industry which was flourishing. And over the years, it flourished a lot. But then a lot of businesses entered this real estate business. A lot of real estate has been built up. A lot of people have invested over there. And now the prices rose to such a high amount that the people were not able to buy this property because it was too costly. Because of which we had a standstill in this industry, and finally now we are seeing a downfall where people are not able to buy this property. The prices have begun to fall and the property prices are falling and the industry is not doing well. In such a kind of a situation, Evergrande already has a debt. Initially, it took a lot of debt from the banks, from the financial institutions. It borrowed, and through those borrowings, it acquired different assets. Unhone apne alag alag real estate projects banaye, khub sari property banayi, alag alag businesses mein bhi diversify kiya. To sara debt ka amount unhone leke invest kar diya assets mein. Ab un assets ki value nahi reh gayi, jo aapki real estate market hai, wo wahan pe uski value kam hona shuru ho gayi properties ki. To ab unke assets ki value kam hai aur wo assets log khareedne ko ready nahi hai. तो उनके पास कैश नहीं आ पा रहा जिससे कि वो अपनी डेट रीपे कर पाए. दिस इज द सिचुएशन विच दिस कंपनी इज फेसिंग. बैंक स्टॉप लेंडिंग टू द प्रॉपर्टी डेवलपर आफ्टर इट्स कैश फ्लो स्लोड. इट्स रेटिंग डाउन गॉट डाउनग्रेडेड. सो क्रेडिट रेटिंग एजेंसीज ने उनकी रेटिंग कम कर दी है. कैश फ्लो वो जनरेट नहीं कर पा रहे. डेट उनकी इतनी ज़्यादा है. लिक्विडिटी इशूज है. दैट्स वाई दिस कंपनी इज गोइंग इन टू अ सिचुएशन ऑफ अ क्राइसिस. Evergrande has been struggling to pay the suppliers. It even told the investors that it could default on debt. So one of the letters got leaked that Evergrande has received help from the government to provide some support because they are not having the money to repay their debt. वो अपनी debt नहीं repay कर पा रहे. वो अपने suppliers को जो पैसा देना है वो नहीं pay कर पा रहे. So overall इनकी situation काफी खराब हो चुकी है and we might see this company going into situation of a bankruptcy. The company has offered to repay debt in the form of property and parking spaces, but people want their cash back. अब वो उनके पास जो भी property, जो भी parking space है, वो sell करने को ready है. But the value of those properties, those parking spaces has downgraded, so people are not willing to buy that. They want their money back, and the company is in a situation where it is not able to pay back that money. So how did this very thing happen? Evergrande was caught by new limits that China's regulators imposed on the real estate borrowing as a part of Communist Party's campaign to reduce reliance on debt. So initially, a lot of relaxation was provided on the borrowings for these real estate sectors. So companies like Evergrande borrowed a lot and used that money to invest in different assets to build their real estate. But then seeing the situation having negative impact on other sectors, the Chinese regulators decided to put curbs on the borrowings of these property developers. So उन्होंने restrictions लगा दी कि इससे ज़्यादा borrowing नहीं कर सकती companies. So because of which now Evergrande is not able to borrow more and it is not generating cash flows from any of the means. The real estate market has slowed down. They are not able to generate the money from the property they are having. So the situation is such that they are not getting money from anywhere and thus they cannot repay their debt. So to counter that, Evergrande tried selling off some of its businesses, but a progressive slowing down of China's property market, tapering demand for new houses crimped their cash flows. So government ne restriction laga di aur borrowing nahi milegi. Iske alawa jo property unke paas already hai uski value itni kam ho gayi ki usko bech ke bhi paise nahi aayenge. और कोई भी इंस्टीट्यूशंस वगैरह उसको लेंड करने के लिए रेडी नहीं है. सो इस सिचुएशन में वो ऑलरेडी अपनी पुरानी डेट नहीं रीपे कर पा रही. उसको और कहीं से पैसे भी नहीं आ रहे. तो कैश फ्लो की प्रॉब्लम है. लिक्विडिटी क्रंच ही कंपनी फेस कर रही है. द कंपनी इज नाउ स्ट्रगलिंग अंडर अ 300 बिलियन बर्डन लाइबिलिटीज बर्डन दैट हैज डेसिमेटेड इट्स क्रेडिट रेटिंग इट्स शेयर प्राइस. उसके शेयर प्राइस अराउंड 80% तक कम हो चुके हैं. इट हैज फेस्ड नियरली 800 unfinished residential buildings, many unpaid suppliers and over a million home buyers who have partially paid for their properties. लोगों ने प्रॉपर्टी के आधे आधे पैसे दिए और पैसे नहीं आ रहे. 800 ऐसी उनकी residential buildings हैं जो उनकी प्रॉपर्टी के projects हैं जो unfinished हैं, जो पूरे नहीं हो पा रहे. वो अपने suppliers को पैसा नहीं दे पा रहे हैं. कहीं से पैसे नहीं आ रहे. उनका सारा business रुका हुआ है. This is the major problem which they are facing. So, talking about the effects it is having on the countries worldwide, first of all, the ones who will be major hit are the creditors, investors and suppliers. Jinhone paisa provide kiya tha, banks ne, financial institutions ne, jin suppliers ne material provide kiya tha, jinhe abhi tak apne saman ki payment nahi mili thi, they are the ones who are going to be hit immediately because of the downfall of this very company. Then the investors who have invested money in this company. Many people might, it's not just the banks and the financial institutions who have provided them the loans, but they might also have raised the funding through the equity shares, through the bonds. So all those who have invested in the company, if the company fails, they are going to lose out on a lot of money. So creditors, investors, suppliers, in pe to turant immediate impact dikhega ye company agar fail ho jati hai to. इसके अलावा बाकी जो ग्लोबल शेयर मार्केट्स हैं उन पे भी इम्पैक्ट आया है इस कंपनी के डाउनफॉल का. द लूमिंग क्राइसिस एट एवरग्रैंड हैज पुल्ड डाउन द ग्लोबल शेयर मार्केट्स लाइक द चाइनीज, ताइवान, साउथ कोरियन मार्केट्स हैव सीन अ ड्रॉप. S&P 500, Dow Industrials, Nasdaq Composite, they have seen a major downfall which has happened in over 2 months. एकदम वर्स्ट हिट हुई है उनकी मार्केट्स. Some analysts fear that the default by Evergrande could topple China's property market, sending ripples worldwide. इससे चाइना की जो प्रॉपर्टी मार्केट है उस पर तो बहुत मेजर इफेक्ट आएगा ही, लेकिन वर्ल्डवाइड मार्केट्स भी इससे इफेक्ट हो सकती है. Many recall the Lehman Brothers financial crisis of 2008. So when the US financial crisis happened, Lehman Brothers was the investment bank which went into bankruptcy because government didn't come to rescue the company. So many analysts are thinking that it can be a Lehman moment for China as well. But the way the things happened with Lehman is quite different from Evergrande. Evergrande is a real estate business. Lehman was an investment banker. It had exposure to lot of financial institutions which this Evergrande does not have. So it might not be a Lehman moment, but still there are chances that the company might go into bankruptcy, but there are also chances that the government will come to rescue and save this company from basically failing up. So company ko, is company ko fail hone se government ho sakta hai bacha le, kyunki real estate bahut badi market hai China ki jo bahut zyada growth ko contribute karti hai. So if a company, such a major company like Evergrande will fail, obviously it's going to hamper the financial system of China. The Chinese government will not want such a situation to happen, and obviously there are high chances that it will come and rescue this company. So China's Evergrande Group's debt crisis might not be a China's Lehman moment, but it like that has sent ripples through stocks tied to developer and the world's second biggest economy. So China ki market mein aur alag alag jagah pe iske hame negative effects dekhne ko mil gaye hain. China is the biggest steel importer in the world, and Evergrande's construction used lot of imported steel. So if this company will fail, then the markets who are providing the steel to China, those market will face a setback. अब जैसे इंडिया अगर चाइना को इतना ज़्यादा स्टील एक्सपोर्ट करता है तो इंडिया के एक्सपोर्ट्स कम हो जाएंगे इस कंपनी के फेल होने की वजह से. Besides, around 29% of China's GDP is related to real estate. So fall of Evergrande will leave a dent in the Chinese economy. China का major growth जो है वो ये रियल एस्टेट मार्केट की वजह से हो रही है. तो इतनी बड़ी अगर रियल एस्टेट कंपनी फेल हो जाएगी तो उसका बहुत नेगेटिव इम्पैक्ट होगा चाइना पे. और वो सिचुएशन अगर कोविड के बाद आएगी, बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड देयर हैज बीन अ लॉट ऑफ डिसरप्शन. सो अ सिचुएशन लाइक दैट ऑफ अ फेलिंग रियल एस्टेट मार्केट कैन स्लो डाउन द इकोनॉमिक ग्रोथ ऑफ द कंट्री इवन फर्दर. सो दैट्स व्हाई देयर आर हाई चांसेस दैट द गवर्नमेंट विल कम एंड रेस्क्यू दिस वेरी कंपनी. सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द क्राइसिस एंड ऑल अबाउट टुडे सेशन. विद दिस आई वुड लाइक टू एंड अप दिस सेशन. थैंक यू सो मच.